So today we'll be looking at simplifying like terms, or what others would say, simplifying expressions. So expression is when you have letters without any equal sign, or even numbers without equal sign, or numbers and letters together without an equal sign. So these are all examples of expressions, okay? The word simplify means make it smaller, make it compact. So if you look at this, we have A plus A plus A. So if I want to simplify this, then what it means is that instead of having A plus A plus A, they want me to write it together as one. Together as one, that's the meaning of simplifying. Okay, so here, I have to first consider, are the letters the same? So in this example, it's very easy to know because the letters are all the same. It's A, A, and A. So then I ask myself, how many of them are there? All the symbols or the sign are plus, so it just means add. So I have one A here, plus one A here, plus one A here, which gives me 3A. So the simplest form or the simplified form of A plus A plus A is 3A. This is the basic, very simple one. But let's look at this one here. We have numbers with letters, numbers with letters. Different letters together. That brings us to the like terms. To be able to simplify this, we must first locate or look for all the letters that are the same. The letters that are the same. So I'm going to put a circle around the letters that are C. So I can see this is 4C. I look through it, I can see there's another C here. So I'll circle it like that. Okay. So I have seen the C all put into circle. Now somebody would ask, why have I circled the plus? It's very important because this is some of the common mistakes that students make. The plus is the sign in front of the number 3, which is part of the C. So that sign is telling me that this 3C is positive. People make mistake thinking because there's a minus sign here, it means you have to do take away. No. Each sign affects only the number that the sign is in front of. So here, though this is minus, the minus is in front of the 5, not in front of the 3. So the 3 is not minus, it's positive. That's why I've circled that. So then all I have to do is look at the letters that I have circled. Here is 4C. Here is plus 3C. They both have C. So I can work that together. So I can do my 4C plus 3C. That gives me 7C. So I have finished with the C. Now I go and find another different letter. Here the letter is D. I need to find another letter that is D, and this is the letter here. So I'll put that in a box so that we can see the difference here. Okay, so my letters in the box start with minus 5D plus 2D. So I can do that separately, minus 5D plus 2D. Okay, if you are confused with your positive and negative numbers, it's easy, just draw your number line, which I have down here. Okay, so it means I'm on minus 5. I go to minus 5, and I'm going to move from minus 5 up to 2. So I'm moving 2. Because it's positive, you're moving to the right side. So in this case, I'm on minus 5, count 2 to the right side, that is minus 4, minus 3. So in this case, this will be minus 3D. So when I combine the C letters together, I had 7C. Combine the D letters together, that gave us minus 3D. Now I can put the two together. It becomes 7C plus, sorry, the sign is minus, so minus 3D. So you put the sign that you got, so 7C minus 3D. In this one, we cannot do anything to them. The reason being that this is letter C, this is letter D. They are different. So it's like saying a boy take away a girl. That is not possible. So you have to leave it as it is. Therefore, the simplified form is this one. So So the answer to this particular one is 7C minus 3D. Now let's quickly look at this one. We have a lot of terms here, different ones. Again, let's do it the same way. Let's start off with those that have the X only. You can see here there is X and Y. Here there is only X, this is only X. So let's circle the ones with only the X there. Okay, so we go with this one as well. I'll always circle the sign because it tells you what to do. Okay, so in this case, let's do the ones with only letter X first. So we have 4X minus X. Okay, it's X, which means it's 1X. So people get confused and think there isn't anything. There's one there, but we don't write it. So it's 4X take away 1X. That gives you 3X. Now we finish with the X only. Let's find the Y only letters. Here, I'll put a box around that. Put a box around this one. Okay, so in this case, we have 5Y. Because it's positive, I don't need to write a plus. Because if you don't write a plus in front of a number, it just means it's positive anyway. Then take away 2y. Okay, again, 5 minus 2 gives you 3. So that would be 3y. Now we left with one of the terms. This is minus 13xy. If I look at the question, there isn't any other term that has x and y together, which therefore means there's nothing I can do to this. So I'll keep this as part of my final answer. So let's write our final answer from here. We have 3x. Now there isn't any sign in front of this, so that means it's plus, not minus. So that becomes plus 3y. And don't forget, there is one term that we didn't use. We have to bring it as part of our answer. So in this term, it has a minus sign in front of it. So we have to bring the minus and write our 13xy. These are different. Even though this is x, this is y, they are different from when they are written together. Therefore, I cannot add these two, neither can I take these two away. So I'll leave this as my simplified answer. So we would have 3x plus 3y minus 13xy from this. Now let's look at another example. In this example, sometimes it's very confusing because all the letters are A. So you might think they are the same. They are not. The trick is you have to look at the powers of the letters. So in this one, there's A with a small 2 at the top, which we call squared. This doesn't have that number at the top. This has the small 2 at the top, which is also squared. This does not. So let's circle all the ones that has the small 2 at the top, which we call it as squared. So circle this one. Circle this one. Remember to always circle the sign as well. So let's do them first. We have 3a squared, okay, minus a squared. Remember from this example, I said there is one there. So this means 1a squared. So we have 3 take away 1. That gives you 2a squared, okay? Now let's look at the remaining letters. This is just a. That is just A, so we can work those together. So we put that in our box, okay, so we know which ones we are working with. So now let's do the ones in our boxes. So that is 5A, okay, that is plus 2A, all right? If I add that 5 plus 2, that gives me 7A. Now let's combine our two answers, write them together. We would have 2A squared. Okay, plus, because there isn't any sign here, so 7a. In some questions, you may be able to leave your answer in this form, but in some questions too, they would expect that because they both have a and a, there is something that we call factorize out. Okay, so they are common letters here. They are the same letters in this way, so I can bring one of them outside. This has 2 at the top, this has only 1. So it means I can bring that one out, bring the A out, put the rest inside the bracket. I haven't used the 2, so I can put the 2 back in the bracket. This has squared. Squared means there are 2 of them. I've used 1 of them, so I'm left with 1 of them. Put that here, so that becomes 2A. When we come to this side, put your sign plus. There's only 1 A here. And I've used that 1A at the front there. So I'm only left with the number 7. and I put that inside my bracket. So this and that are the same answers. You may be able to leave it in this way, but depends on the question. If they really want it very simplest form, then we prefer that you factorize the letter out and leave your answer in this way. So that is how we simplify like terms. Always look for the common letters together. As I said, to prevent making mistakes, circle them, those that are the same. Make sure you circle the sign as well, so that when you are writing them, you will not be confused with the sign. Because sometimes people look at this first sign here and they use it. So make sure you don't make that mistake and you should get it right. So thank you.